Joe here in a minute underwater. And as you watch Uncle Joe, think of things you'd like to ask him. And as questions come in here, we're going to be picking out some of them, relaying them to Uncle Joe underwater. So let's see if we can go join Uncle Joe right now down on an artificial reef.
Well, hello, Patty. Everybody from ReefQuest. This is Uncle Joe, and man, am I in a current. Boy, this is unbelievable, unbelievable. But I'm going to take you on a dive. We're live underwater at 60 feet, and we're going to see an absolutely incredible artificial reef. So let me move my hand down this chain and point my video camera to this wreck. This is a wreck that is now the artificial reef. It is a YO57, a yard oiler. This ship was actually built in 1944. It was sunk intentionally in 1989 and used as this artificial reef. So we're going to move into this very unusual ship. I want you in the audience, Patty, to look at all the fish around here. Many of these fish are feeding on plankton in the water. They graze upon algae on the ship. So I'm moving my camera in. We'll start to see some of these fish and how they feed. Now, we're going to move into what I call the penthouse, the upper area of this ship, and this then would be the wheelhouse, or the deck area where the captain or the skipper of the ship takes hold. So let me again try to cram through this little cubby hole with my regulator. The current is really pulling my line. Try to make it inside. Yeah, I'm in here. Now you can see the fish in front. Those are what's called yellow and black milkseed butterfly fish, probably one of the most abundant butterfly fish. And what you're looking at now is the steering wheel. This is the steering wheel of the ship. I'll try to grab onto it here. The wooden area then is eroded away, but you can still see the brass spokes, and even the wheel then is the home for many of these encrusting organisms. And Patty, I think I'm attracting a lot more of these lemon butterfly fish and these milkseed butterfly fish coming into the area. Let me point my video camera out one of the forward portholes. You see Randy, one of my safety divers, in the background. And all this stuff on the inside of the wreck then is various encrusting animals. We have Dan back there tending the cable on the anchor chain from this very unusual wreck site. But I'm going to go outside now. I can see many of the fish in the area. I'm going to move out to what's called the gangway, the deck gangway, even the plates of the ship. Completely encrusted then with various algaes and small corals. Let me move backward. This current is just unbelievable. You'll see a lot of other yellow-lined snappers in here. We'll see some trumpet fish and a lot of goatfish that make this artificial reef. They're full-time residents, Patty. Pointing the video camera downward, this is the deck, the main deck of this yard oiler. It is actually a perfect structure then for many of these animals on this artificial reef. Oh, Patty, this has been an absolutely incredible dive here today.
Okay, we've got a question from Mountain View right now here in, on the Big Island. Mountain View, who is there?
Blake.
Okay, and Blake, what's your question here?
How do they repair live reefs?
How do they repair live reefs?
Blake, that's a very good question. Until recently, we really haven't repaired many of these reefs, but now scientists are trying to actually transplant corals. If you remember a show not too long ago, Dr. Carlton of the Waikiki Aquarium talked about replanting some of the block corals, which I thought was very fascinating. But what we're trying to do even more is to actually put down these artificial reefs, these structures then, which allow material, algae, corals, and then fish to actually accumulate on. You can see Randy ducking into one of the holes on the smokestack. There occasionally is a moray eel that lives down there. Randy is trying to see if he can see him. I'm going to move my video camera back on the inside of the wheelhouse, Patty, because what we're going to talk about in the next segment are the encrusting animals, the corals, the algae, and all, that actually live on the side of this hull.
And let's go to Naylor Middle School here in Tucson, Arizona. Do you guys have a question about what you're seeing here? Naylor, who is there?
Daniel.
Daniel, what's your question?
How long have they had the ship sunk?
Good question. How long has the ship been down there?
Daniel, the ship was actually retired from the service in 1982, but sunk, intentionally sunk, in September of 1989. That makes it in about 8 years. So it allows scientists to tell the growth rate of these corals and really, really just how many fish can occupy this area. Now, I know that many of the studies down here before had a baseline, had an original idea of the number of fish, but after putting this wreck down, scientists tell us, Daniel, that the fish population increased by over 1,000 times. That's really incredible.
Okay, we're going to leave Uncle Joe here for a few minutes, and we'll come back and see if he can find another place.